decided to discuss, well, my partner decided to discuss inland terrorism, and to go against my opponent, saying that, yeah, we need to deal with our situation, but the refugees will make it healthcare worse. He also said about the economy, how's 10,000 gonna help the economy, but how is 10,000 people exactly going to worsen healthcare and the healthcare situation? Healthcare situation for American citizens by itself is already complicated. We also talked about, we also mentioned earlier about the screening that they go through, Americans go through tests. I also wanted to touch on the process that they go through, and that also, we also talked about Syrians moving away. Those that are born here, they move away to Syria, native-borns. But I wanted to talk about that not all of them are typically bad, like the ones that come in, because there is a process that goes to promote reunification. So mainly the ones that come here are trying to be unified with their family, and while that may have an effect on healthcare and the economy, the Syrian refugees aren't the only ones immigrating to the United States. That kind of touches back on my part about ideals. But I wanted to discuss the process in which the family can go to reunification. There is a process the government has created called Priority 2, which allows refugees to come into the U.S. through their relatives. If they are granted this, they are free of the screening, but this doesn't affect the safety process as well. If this happens, the scanning process happens for their family, and so that also helps with the inland, those inside the United States. As in, those inside the United States aren't all terrorists as well. They are contributing, they are working, they do help the economy. The 10,000 that are accepted, you mentioned the exact 10,000, but compared to other states, other countries, all 10,000 is a minor amount of refugees that are accepted. Canada has accepted, according to Time magazine, around 27,000. And that's not the first time that refugees have been helped. The United States has helped refugees as well. In 1978, after the Vietnam War, they accepted 125,000 refugees, even though the war had just been finished. Though our country is not directly, with ISIS. The 10,000 we have is going to contribute.